government's unconstitutional adoption of the Patriot Act, the unconstitutional bailout of AIG and other private banks with trillions of public dollars, and for reprints of the government's disregard for the Constitution and the rule of law in a variety of other ways throughout the years. Those repeated petitions also have been answered only by repeated injury. What do we do about it? Bob is now asking that question. We're all asking that question. What does the free people do about those privileges today in the face of such disregard by our government? There is something we can do about it, and do about it now. The We the People Foundation has decided it's time to hold a new Continental Congress to accept these grievances and to find a peaceful, constitutional means of making our government address those grievances, to make the government fully and completely respect our Constitution and the rule of law. You can be part of this historic event, the Continental Congress 2009. Your participation and assistance is essential to its success. The Continental Congress 2009 will be held from November 9th through November 24th. Who will be attending the Continental Congress? Three delegates from each state with a proven passion for the Constitution will be chosen in a general election by paper ballot on October 10th. You can be one of those delegates. Nominations are being accepted right now for the Connecticut delegates to Congress 2009. No politicians, absolutely not. Yeah. The Congress 2009 is a massive but necessary undertaking. To help fund this historic event, the We the People Foundation would greatly appreciate any donation from the board to give, and all donations are tax deductible. If you would like to nominate someone or nominate yourself to be a Connecticut delegate, or if you'd like to help us get the word out, please see me here today or log on to givemeliberty.org. The Continental Congress 2009 will be a national assembly of the people, held in the spirit of facts of what has and is taking place. Resulting effects on our nation and what can be done to insist that the Constitution be obeyed and restored. I will end by quoting from Bob Schultz. Freedom cannot be achieved by words and good intentions. It is reserved for those who are prepared to risk everything for its eternal blessing. Many of those who have gone before us have paid the ultimate price to secure the blessings of liberty for future generations of Americans, including ours. We owe no less to our own children and grandchildren. With hearts inspired by the love of God and country, we the people must confront and turn back those forces that seek to destroy our Constitution and our Bill of Rights. Please join us.